Hello children, let's learn about the keyboard special keys. So in the previous classes you have already learned about a keyboard. Before we learn about the new keys on the keyboard, let's do a quick recap of what we have learned in the previous classes. Let's have a quick recap of a keyboard. So till now we have learned that keyboard is an input device. The small buttons on the keyboard are known as keys. Keyboard is used to type words, numbers, and special symbols. A standard keyboard has 104 keys. Alphabet keys. There are 26 alphabet keys on a keyboard. They are from A to Z. They are used to type letters and words. They are arranged in QWERTY form and not in a sequence. Number keys or numeric keys. There are two sets of number keys on the keyboard. They are used to type numbers. Each set has 10 number keys from 0 to 9. They are present above the alphabet keys and on the right side of the keyboard, known as numeric keypad. So as you all know that for numbers we have two sets. The first set is present above the alphabet keys. And the second set is present towards the right side of the keyboard, which is also known as the numeric keypad. And to use the numeric keypad, you have to press a special key. So do you all remember what that special key is? Let's see. So here is the numeric keypad. And switch on the num lock to use the numeric keypad. So you have to press the num lock key once. And once you press the num lock key, there's a light on the right hand side which says num lock will start blinking. Once this light is on, your num lock is on and now you can use the numeric keypad to type the numbers. You switch this key, you press this key again and this will be switched off. Once the num lock is switched off, you will not be able to use the numeric keypad to type the numbers. After learning about the alphabet keys and the number keys, let's learn about the special keys present on a keyboard. There are different special keys present on the keyboard to perform specific tasks. So there are different special keys present on a keyboard and every special key has a specific task to do. That is why they are known as special keys. On this keyboard, you can see a few special keys marked. Let's start from the left hand side where I have the caps lock key marked in red. Then at the bottom, there is a space bar marked in blue. Then you have a set of arrow keys, which is also known as the control keys. Above the arrow keys, you have the enter keys. There are two enter keys present on a keyboard. Then you have a delete key marked in orange, a backspace key marked in pink, and then you have some special symbols present above the number keys marked in purple. Let's learn about the space bar. If this is my keyboard, can you see the key at the bottom row? This is the space bar. Let's learn about it. There is only one space bar on the keyboard. It is the longest key of the keyboard. So as you can see, there are small keys on the keyboard, but the biggest, the longest key on the keyboard is the space bar. It is present in the bottom row. So as you can see, the spacebar is present at the bottom row. This key is used to give spaces between words, letters or numbers. So what is the function of the spacebar? That we use spacebar to give a space between two words. Whenever you write in the notebook, you give spaces between the words. Similarly, when you type on the computer, when you type using a keyboard, to give spaces between words, you need to use spacebar. About the caps lock key. So if this is my keyboard, at the left hand side of the keyboard, there is a key which says caps lock. There is only one caps lock key on the keyboard. It is like a switch. We have to switch it on to write the letters in capital. Once switched off, we can type in small letters. So, what is the function of the caps lock key? See, as you all know that we have only one set of alphabet keys on the keyboard, and we have to use this one set to type in capital as well as type in the lowercase. So if we want to type in capital letters, we have to switch on this key. So once I press on this key, I will get a light on it. Once this light is on, I will be able to type in capital. And when I press this key again, the light will switch off and I will be able to type in small letters. So that is the function of a caps lock key. So I hope you enjoyed learning about the spacebar and the caps lock key. Now let's see how do we use these keys on a computer. So children, let's see how the spacebar and the caps lock key work. So this is my screen where I'll be typing. Right? And here is the virtual keyboard that you can see. So on this keyboard, this caps lock is on right now. Let me switch it off. Now can you see? All the letters are appearing in lowercase because the caps lock is off. But on your real keyboard, when the caps lock key is on, there is a light which blinks on the caps lock key. So when I switch on the caps lock key and I use my keys for typing, then all the letters are coming in capital. Right? Now let's try doing the same thing when I switch off the caps lock key. Now I press this key again and the caps lock key is off. Now when I write, all my letters are coming in the lowercase. Right? So this is how the caps lock key is used. So once you switch it on, you find everything in capital, you can write in capital letters. If it is switched off, you can write in the lowercase. Okay? Now let's use the spacebar key. What is the function of the spacebar key? It gives spaces between the words, letters or numbers. Now suppose I want to write computer. Is, and electronic device. Now, is it looking like a sentence? Is this looking like a sentence? No, it is just like a single word. Right? Because I don't have any spaces between the words. So, it is looking like a single word. And I'm not able to read it. Now, let's use spacebar and write the sentence again. computer. Now after computer, I want a space. So let me use a space bar. See, I have a space now. Now when I write is, it will come after a space. Now I use the space bar again. And space electronic. Space device. So can you see the difference between both the sentences when I use a space bar? When I use the space bar, this is looking like a sentence. I can differentiate between each word. So after one word, I have a space. Then again a word, then I have a space and word. Space, and then again another word and a space. But when I'm not using a space bar, this will not look like a sentence. Alright, so this is the function of a space bar key. Children, I hope you enjoyed learning about both the keys today. So till we meet next, keep learning and thank you for watching this video.